The date, November the 26th, 1941. At 6 o'clock that morning, a fleet of 20 warships, including 6 aircraft carriers, slipped out of a harbor in northern Japan. The destination, the island group of Hawaii, and more specifically, the islands of Oahu, with its American naval base, Pearl Harbor. The Japanese ships reached their land point under radio silence by the end of the first week of December. And in the early morning of the 7th, 183 planes took off from their carrier decks towards their target.
Sunday morning, 7th of December, 6 a.m. Signal flags waved down. On Japanese carriers, aircraft engines spurted into life. Down flight decks one by one amid the cheers that burst out from the ship's crews. Plane after plane rose from the decks, glinting in the low dawn sun just peeping over the horizon, until the first wave of 183 aircraft were in the air. Dead ahead, on the island of Oahu, lay their targets, open to unsuspected attack from the skies above. Battleships, cruisers, all laid out so neat and tidy side by side. An orderly array of planes on airfields, drawn up close together, ironically, to avoid sabotage.
At 7:53 a.m., as the people of the island prepared for a pleasant and relaxed Sunday morning, the planes were given the order for attack. Tora, tora, tora. 2 minutes later, the first wave of torpedo bombers released their loads and changed the war from a strictly European affair into a war that was to engulf the world.
...7:49 a.m. The order to get ready to attack. ...7:55 a.m. The Japanese dive bombers open their devastating first bombardment. U.S. airfields were systematically wiped out in scarcely minutes, and the sudden awareness of something awful happening gripped the people of Hawaii in the streets. What took place over the airfield was merely a prelude to the carnage soon to descend upon the harbor itself. dive bombers, torpedo bombers dropped their loads upon the ships below, creating clouds of thick, dark, oily smoke as the peaceful harbor was shattered by explosions. As the first wave of bombers completed their sorties, a second wave of 171 aircraft followed in support. But most of the damage had been done in the first brief quarter of an hour. In just that small span of time, the Japanese had immobilized or wiped out the entire air power of the Hawaii base, and then almost totally destroyed the complete United States Pacific Fleet. In barely 2 hours, the key U.S. military fortress of Pearl Harbor had been utterly pulverized. It made the German blitzkrieg in Europe seem almost laborious by comparison. The final toll of 2 hours' warfare was horrendous. 2,335 servicemen dead, 1,178 wounded, 18 ships, including 7 battleships, sunk or damaged almost beyond repair. Over 200 Army and Navy planes destroyed or beyond use. The Japanese losses were only 29 planes, 6 submarines, and about 150 men. The drone of disappearing Japanese aircraft dwindled in the distance. Behind, they left a scene of crackling flames and hissing steam, the cries of injured men. Once proud ships lay submerged to their very superstructures, overturned or tilted at bizarre angles, wreckage and bodies floating in the sea of oil. The great gray ships burned at their moorings in the morning sun over Hawaii.
Yesterday, December 7, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. On Sunday, December 7th, 1941, a state of war has existed between the United States and the Japanese Empire.
The United States was now at war. Winston Churchill's prayers had been answered. Great Britain had her much-needed ally. A few days later, on the 13th of December, Churchill set sail in the battleship, the Duke of York, to meet Roosevelt for discussion on the Allied war plan. The global situation at this time can be summed up as improved in Europe and the Middle East, but disastrous in the Far East and Pacific.
Island after Pacific island, mainland bases fell literally day by day. Wake Island, Guam, Hong Kong, the shores of Southeast Asia. On Christmas Eve, the Japanese landed on the main island of America's major base in the South Pacific, the Philippines. Its commander, General MacArthur, was forced to abandon it. He was ordered to Australia to set